before we talk about the budget, why was the mic shut off when Kabataan Party List Group Representative Raul Manuel was speaking? Was that necessary?
To be honest, Karen, we also do not know where his claim was coming from. Because in fact, I was on the other microphone. I wanted also to point order in the House because of the process. And we noticed that the majority leader also the microphone of the majority leader was also not switched on. That's why, if you will notice, it somehow dragged. And we were calling the attention. I'm not sure because prior to that, kumidlate. So if you can see, we even requested a technical team to look into the microphone because even the microphone of the majority leader had technical difficulties.
Okay, so what you're saying, number one, is nobody else can control the microphone on the podium. Only the person speaking. Is that correct?
No, all the microphones had technical difficulties. And I believe Kong Manuel, his microphone was on, but the majority leader and the other members, like myself, wanted to stand up because it was actually not in order anymore. Just to point out, Kong Manuel, Kong Raul, stood up for a point of order. And the chair ruled that he was out of order because he was questioning the certificate of urgency issued by the president. When a ruling has been determined, then you cannot actually explain. What Kong Manuel should have done was to appeal the ruling of the chair.
But then it was very difficult. But do you appeal also using the microphone?
Yes. So your motion will the motion of Kong Raul was actually to point to he stood up on a point of order. And the presiding officer asked what the point of order was, and he was referring to the certificate of urgency issued by the president. And he was overruled because you cannot question the certificate issued by the president. Yeah. So what he should have done is to appeal and then explain. But then he kept on talking, so it was already chaotic.
Uh-oh.
And that was actually out of order.
But are you saying that there was no intention to turn his mic off?
Nobody turned his microphone off.
What it seems publicly is there was an intention to shut him up and railroad the passage.
No, Karen. Nobody turned off his microphone. In fact, it was only his microphone that was functioning in the whole floor. The microphone of the majority leader had technical difficulties, and I stood up on a point of order simply because session was already chaotic and he should have appealed and explained his appeal rather than talking on the microphone and pointing accusations to whoever he was pointing at. So, but then we were not heard because all our microphones were put on off. If you can remember, Congressman Ed Salagman also stood up. I was in front of him. He was behind me. Both our microphones were not functioning.
Okay, so let's move on from that. The budget's been passed, right? So we're talking about 5.7 trillion pesos. This is a 9.5% increase from last year's budget. The House leaders, also leaders of different parties, have said there's been an agreement that the confidential budget from certain civilian agencies will be realigned. So ang tanong, bakit hindi ito, Congresswoman, ni-realign bago ipinasa ang budget? Let's start with that.
First, Karen, that has been the practice of Congress over several years that I have been a member of Congress for purposes of expediency. Remember, we are 312 congressmen, and each of us would have amendments. So there's a small committee that tackles it. Like, for example, on my part, I have a pending proposed amendment that the 50 million confidential fund of the Department of Agriculture be instead realigned to anti-smuggling campaign of the department. I also have a pending proposal that, for example, the DICT, the Office of the Secretary of the ICT has a proposed confidential fund of 300 million for 2024 in contrast to the Coast Guard, the Philippine Coast Guard, and the DOJ that has lesser note. The Coast Guard is only 10 million and the DOJ Office of the Secretary has around 250 million. So yung po yung mga, just imagine if the 312 congressmen, eh pagdidipatihan yung bawat item, no? Eh, isa lang naman yung purpose. So it will really delay and it will be chaotic. That's why individual amendments are tackled by a small committee being elected by the House.
Okay, so now that it's passed, any realignment can happen only in the BICAM, correct?
In the small committee.
Oh, okay, let's talk about that. So even before the BICAM, the small committee can already realign?
Yes, and they accept the proposals of the members. And marami po yan, more than half
so
of the members
yun,
of the Congress.
Take me through this, Congresswoman, because this is a new entity here, the small committee. So pag
realign, No, Karen. It's not a new entity, sorry. It's not a new entity. That has been the process since I became congressman in 2004.
No, I meant is the budget's been passed at 5.7 trillion in certain agencies. So pumasa na. So ang sinabi ni Congressman Pimentel kasi, tinanong ko bakit hindi tinanggal bago ipasa. He said the same thing, matatagalan. So he said sabay kam na tatanggalin. So you said that small committee can remove it. But then will the Senate accept what's been removed by the small committee as part of the budget that was passed?
That is where the BICAM will come into
That's
place.
That's the point. Yun na nga. So, tama si Congressman Pimentel. In the end, BICAM. So, my sources tell me that there's a possibility that all of the CONFI budget of the Vice President, OVP, DepEd, 650 million of it will be realigned. Is this true?
We leave it to the chairman of the committee to make such announcement. No? Because the way we are looking, ngayon pa lang kasi, Monday, all of this will be deliberated. I believe the deadline for the submissions will be today. And, but the small committee has already been deliberating since immediately after the Congress went into recess. So, ang baka naman may baka naman may iwan. For DepEd siguro baka medyo maiwanan, no? Pero meron rin kasi ibang ahensya na hindi lang napansin, like I was saying DICT. DICT, the confidential fund was also 300 million where in fact for 2021, 2022 and 2023 this was zero. So meron ding mga ganyan, no? It's not just focus on the office of the vice president. It's focus on the whole entity of how the confidential fund. Yun nga eh, Karen, ang daming nakiuso at naabuso na rin, no? I mean, I'm not referring to the OVP or DepEd, but if you look at the historical data, the jump started in 2017 where the total confidential fund in 2016 was 720 million. In 2017, it jumped to 2.07 billion. At makikita mo, pagdating ng 2020, it more than doubled to 4.57 billion. Tumaas ng tumaas yung confidential fund. Pero ngayon, ang nakikita natin is tila hindi siya napunta sa mga tamang ahensya na dapat taasan if we are talking about national security. For example, the OTS, no, yung DOTR OTS, maliit lang naman, no? 5 million lang yung kanilang confidential fund. But if you look at the performance of the OTS, parang nakakahiya na yung kaliwat kanan na huli ng mga pagnanakaw sa pasahero natin. So is that justifiable? Parang tila, even with that meager confidential fund, and nakikita natin lalo pang lumada. So the point here is what Congress is looking at is the fact that the party leaders, together with Speaker Martin Romualdez, saw the point na tumaas nga, nagdoble, nagtriple, at naging times four na yung confidential fund. Pero tila hindi siya nailagay dun sa mga nangangailangan. There is a need to prioritize the need rather than the wants.
Well, you gave a very good point there. Even your timeline is quite helpful. So number one, una, naniniwala kayo, marami nang nakikiuso. Yun ang nangyari. Because of the increase in the confidential fund, nakikiuso ang maraming ahensya.
Yes, no, ang daming nagkaroon ng confidential fund at ang daming lumaki ang confidential fund, specifically in 2017. At nung panahon ng pandemya, and that's 2020, nag-double ulit. So it went up to almost 4.6 billion. But then, if I can just Viber email to you the data that I have, marami naman ang may data ng nito, you can see the offices that we're actually getting bulk of the confidential funds. They're civilian agencies. Pero hindi ko, ako personally, hindi ko nakikita kung nagkaroon. But what we should see now is, was there an improvement in terms of their function, in terms of their output for the, let's say, past 5 or 6 years that they started having confidential funds, or for those agencies as confidential funds were astonishing, were surprisingly very much increased.
Okay, so another point that I think we should discuss that you mentioned is the DICT, right? So item nila, was there an item for a confidential fund tapos zero or walang item at all?
In 2019 and 2020 meron, no? But then 2021, 2022, 2023, wala. In the 2024 proposed budget, meron ulit, no? Well, kailangan naman ng DICT. We're not saying that it's not needed. Pero siguro sa dami ng priorities ngayon, baka kay, I mean, it's just my on an individual capacity that is one of my proposal. We leave it, of course, to the decision of the small committee and the whole Congress whether it's sustained by yung 300 million or babawasan ba siya. Kasi kung nakita naman natin,
pero technically,
despite the funds that...
Pero technically, it is not unconstitutional to put confidential funds in the DICT because it's the start of the budget season. I know that the office of the vice president, what's being questioned was in 2022, mid-year, walang item for confidential fund, pinasukan from the contingent fund. So magkaiba po yun, Congresswoman?
Yes, magkaiba siya, Karen. Oh. But then if it's the contingent fund, if we base it on the special provision, the contingent fund can actually fund new programs, current programs, and other programs of urgent concerns. Ang hindi lang pwedeng ponduhan ng contingent fund ay yung purchase of vehicle. So if we are asking about the legality of the release of funds from DBM to OVP, then it's legal. Now, it does not mean to say na kapag na-release na siya, hindi na siya, parang kumbaga wala na, no? It will be now subject to the Joint Circular 201501. So kumbaga, yung accountability is still there, and the auditing procedures that is entailed in the Joint Circular applies to the contingent fund that has now been released used under confidential funds.
Well, actually, Congresswoman, you're quite an expert on this. You should be speaking about this more. So one clarification, you're saying technically contingent fund, let's digress a bit, can fund programs. And true enough, the OVP, what they enumerated was they funded programs, libreng sakay, pakain, learners, planting tree program, etc. So they funded programs. But should it have been labeled as a CONFI fund? If a contingent fund funds programs, what is the label of that fund?
Okay. Based on the documents that we saw, the contingent fund released by DBM to the Office of the Vice President, dalawa po. Isa under social services, which is around, I think, 96 million. And the other one was 125 million for confidential fund. Apat po ang ni-request. I believe the first request, ito yung sa social services. And the request was, if my memory recalls me right, I just don't have the document now, but I believe it was like more or less 200 million plus. After I think 3 or 4 months of deliberation with DBM, DBM made a projection of how much is needed until end of the year. They only approved 96 million. Yung dun naman sa request for additional personnel or allowances and salaries of personnel, it was not approved. And dun naman sa additional funding for security, it was also not approved. The confidential fund, the request was 250 million. What was approved was 125 million. Uh-oh. So dalawa ang naging release.
Pero galing
from
to
contingent
sa contingent fund. Opo. Galing
yes.
to sa contingent
yes.
fund. So when a contingent
yes.
fund is downloaded, do you consider that a download or a transfer? What's the right term? Because some say transfer will make it illegal.
It's not transfer, it's release.
Release, okay.
Parang, yes.
Okay.
Because it's lodged in the DBM. Para siyang MPBF na pagkakailangan mo ng personal benefit, the DBM has this lump sum that can be released to age or to all agencies, any agency that will qualify based on their assessment. So itong
okay.
contingent fund is the same.
Okay.
And the contingent fund for 2024 is 13 billion.
So Congresswoman, pag ni-release ang contingent fund to any agency mid-year, for example, there's an urgent program or something, will that be labeled as a confidential fund or it becomes now a program fund or a program funded by the contingent fund? Kasi ang CONFI funds, there seems to be, I mean, the COA released a memorandum on what you can spend confidential funds on. So kaya confusing to the public. Ano ba talaga? Ang confidential funds under the COA memorandum cannot be spent for programs. Ano po ang tawag doon?
Well, Karen, you're correct, no? From the contingent fund, if it is released for social services ang gagastusan. So the 96 million should be for social services.
Uh-oh.
Now the 125 million was released for confidential fund. Uh-huh. In other words, that
is
will
that
now be
legal?
Covered by the joint to release from the contingent fund to confidential fund. Yes, it's legal. Mm-hmm. However, on the utilization of the confidential fund, it is now subject to the joint circular. So we have, I haven't, because it's, of course, it's only the chairman of the Commission on Audit and the speaker and the president who receives a report of how confidential funds in all agencies have been utilized. At usually, meron din yang mga hindi inaallow ng COA and it will be rectified.
Pero Congresswoman, can't this be abused? This sets a dangerous precedent. From 7 billion ang contingent fund, you told us now it's 13 billion. Kumbaga dumoble pa. Tama?
It was 13 billion in 2023.
Ah, okay.
13 billion also in
7.
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Okay. So, I mean, with this kind of latitude, can't this be abused, frankly, Congresswoman? I mean, it seems that the president and the DBM can make political accommodations mid-year. Here's an agency they want to release the contingent fund to. Pwedeng gawin, right? Is this a good system?
Well,
confidential funds, be frankly, lobbied and fought for and justified during the budget season?
Well, Karen, as far as I can recall, I'm not really the privy to all the releases of the contingent fund.
Uh-oh.
This is probably, I'm not sure, but this is also probably the first time that a confidential fund has been allocated from the contingent fund. No? But then if we go back, the possibility of abuse is there. However, kasi dumadaan yan sa ilang vetting at maraming documents eh. So, so far, the contingent fund is, minsan nga hindi na uubos yan eh. And the usual, I believe Marawi, I think when the problem in Marawi happened, contingent fund was utilized for that. Kung gaya, example, there's a pandemic or there's war in Syria. Remember, there was war in Lebanon. We have to retrieve the Filipino workers in there. So we use contingent fund. Or let's say bigla ang nagka-problema at merong kailangan bayaran ang Pilipinas and wala tayong pambayad, dun siya kukunin,
Dapat
especially if
ganon.
it...
Oo.
Yes, oo.
Okay. All right. Well, Congresswoman Garin, we can talk at length. I do hope to have you back soon after the small committee makes the decision so we can update the public on this. I've run out of time, but thank you so much. I'd have to say it was the lengthiest explanation I've had on the confidential fund so far and the most detailed. Thank you. Thank you, Congresswoman.
Thank you, Karen. God bless.